Shalom, 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 everyone. Welcome. We are still in the Holy Week. We are still commemorating and celebrating this special week that took place 2,000 years ago. 2,000 years ago, Jesus had a difficult week. This week would be his last. Before his death, before his crucifixion, before his burial, and before his resurrection. So we are commemorating and we are celebrating this week. Today's scripture reading will be taken from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 22, verse 39 to verse 46. Luke 22, 39 to verse 46 from the ESV version. So grab your Bibles and let's dive right in. Jesus prays on the Mount of Olives. This same story is in the book of Mark, chapter 14, verse 32 to 42, and also Luke 22, verse 39 to 46. Whenever you see that the same story appears in different of the Gospels, I would highly advise you to read them. Read all the different accounts. Read all the different details. Today, I decided for today's scripture reading that is going to be the book of Luke. And this is talking about Jesus praying at the Mount of Olives in the Garden of Gethsemane. You see, Jesus was a man of prayer. Jesus always took time off from the crowd and from his disciples to go and be alone with his Father in prayer. To go and spend some time with his Father. It says here in verse 39, and he came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. No, not all the disciples. It was literally Jesus' inner circle. So Peter, James, and John. And when he came to the place, the Garden of Gethsemane, he said to them, pray that you may not enter into temptation. So he specifically gave them instructions to pray as well. But of course, they did not pray. Instead, they fell asleep. And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw and knelt down and prayed, saying, Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. You see, it says here that Jesus prayed, remove this cup from me, Father, but nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. Jesus always wanted to please the Father. He always wanted to please the Father, even if it meant sacrificing his own life. Like I said, Jesus was a man of prayer. He always withdrew to pray. But this time, this prayer was different. This time, Jesus would be praying in agony. This time, his soul was deeply troubled. His soul and his spirit was sorrowful because he knew what awaited him. He knew that he had to drink that cup, that bitter cup of God's wrath. He knew that the whole fate of humanity rested upon him dying on that cross. It was not an easy task. And Jesus did not want to do it. It's not a wonder that Jesus was not jumping up to do it. No one would. This was not an easy thing. Crucifixion was horrible. It was the worst death ever that you can ever imagine. It was horrible. It was cruel. There was a lot of suffering, pain, and torture involved. So guess what? No one was jumping in line to be crucified. This was a heavy task. And it was very heavy, all right, because it says here, And there appeared to him an angel from heaven, strengthening him. And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down to the ground. Can you imagine that? That you are praying so intense. This was such an intense prayer that he was sweating blood. That's just to show you, if you can get a visual of how intense, how much in agony Jesus was. Angels came to strengthen him because he was very weak at this moment. He was very weak. And when he rose from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping for sorrow. And he said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Rise and pray that you may not enter into temptation." In the other accounts, in Mark and Matthew, it says that Jesus prayed three times. Three times he went to pray to the Father, and he said, "Father, nothing is impossible for you. If you want, you can remove this cup from me. But nevertheless, your will be done and not mine." He prayed this three times. Three times he left the disciples alone and came back and found them sleeping. He told them, "Pray that you may not fall into temptation." Yet they were fast asleep. They could not remain woke. They could not remain awake. I guess they were very tired. They were walking up and down the place. That whole day they were tired. And at night all they wanted to do was to sleep. But they had no clue of how important this moment was. That they had remained in prayer with Jesus. But they didn't. I often wonder if Peter had prayed, had strengthened himself in the spirit, guess what? He would not have denied Jesus Christ. Takeaway lessons. Number one, Jesus was a man of prayer. We Christians should also be men and women of prayer. We Christians should also take time off from our busy schedules to spend some time with God in prayer. Jesus was a very busy man. He took time. He made time. So can we. Number two, Jesus gave specific instructions to his disciples to stay awake. Stay awake and pray so that they would not fall into temptation. We must also stay awake and pray that we do not fall into temptation, but that the Lord would deliver us from the evil one. And number three, we must also pray that not our will, but God's sovereign will be done in our lives. Just like how Jesus prayed. We pray too much about me, myself, and I. It's always about what we want. But at the end of the day, it's what God wants. That is what matters. So make sure to always remember to pray, "Father, your will, your sovereign will be done in my life. Not my will, but yours." In Jesus' mighty name. That was it for this video. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Shalom, shalom. Bye-bye.